Hi viewers, welcome to LMS Solution. Today we are going to see about off-grid solar PV battery system. In this system, we can see that this is a simulation model for solar PV battery system. The system consists of solar panel. The rating of solar panel is 2000 watts P panel. And then the single panel rating is 250 watts. And then voltage at maximum power point is 30.9 volt. And then current at maximum power point is 8.1 amps. And here we are using 4 series model per string, and then we have 2 parallel string. And here you can see that the IV and PV characteristics of the solar PV panel. The peak power of solar PV panel or PV array going to vary with the change in irradiation. When irradiation reduced, right, the peak power also going to be reduced. Here we need to extract that maximum power or peak power of the solar PV array. For that, here we are using MPPT algorithm, that being PSO MPPT plus battery charger controller. This solar PV output going to be connected to the single phase DC-DC conversion element. That means the output of solar PV directly is fed to the AC load or home load. And also the solar PV output will be directly connected to the battery via this bi-directional converter. The solar PV going to be used for charge the battery as well as single phase, that mean AC load via single phase DC to AC conversion. During that may PV power mode, whenever power available in the PV, that going to be supplied to the battery as well as this AC load. Whenever the power is reducing, what will happen, the first two preference, that mean the solar PV is directly given to this load, the remaining power, excess power will be used to charge the battery. So this is the concept implemented here. And also you can see here, when the solar PV power goes to 0, what happens? The battery is going to be supplied the power to the AC load via this single phase DC to AC converter. Here you are not using any grid system. And also, for example, if suppose there is no power in the PV and then the source of the battery, startup charge of battery is very low, then you can use generator set or AC input. Then going to be supplied this AC load as well as to charge a battery. Further, we have this backup generation. This is also known as backup generator. So we can use generator or AC input directly. We can directly connect to the utility grid in order to charge the battery and this to supply the power to the AC load. This is during no power in the PV and then AC of the battery is having low value, then we can connect this one. This is known as the operation of off-grid solar PV battery system. And here you can see that this here we are using 48 volt battery. The rated capacity is 200 Ah. And then here we are using AC input, and that means this act as a generator set on the AC input. That means this AC input will be converted into DC by using this rectifier, and then it will be filtered by using this LC filter, and then is going to be connected to the bi-directional converter, and also it will be connected to the single phase inverter, and then after filtering it will be try this load or AC load. This inverter will be controlled by means of voltage control and current control. Here we are applying the voltage control concept, and then here we are applying the current control concept. Here we are measuring the voltage of the inverter and then going to be converted into DQ form, and then here we are generating a reference Q and D based upon the reference voltage. Here we are generating the D reference, Q reference based upon the reference voltage. Here we are converting the inverter voltage DQ form. After that, here we are process via PA controller. Actual Q, actual D is going to be compared with the Q reference, Li reference, and then going to be processed via PA controller. And then it will be generating the control signal, the form of D and Q, and then it will be converted into AB form. Here we are going to take only a quantity because of single phase, that will be considered as a reference current, and then here we are measuring the inverter current, and then when we combined with the reference current, and then it's going to be processed via PA controller again, and then it will generate the modulated signal, that will be processed via generator. This pendulum generator going to be control this inverter in order to convert this DC to AC. So this is working of single phase DC to AC conversion for the DAC load. Here we are going to, I'm going to simulate this model. I'm going to explain the operation for different operating condition. Initially, I'm going to make the irradiation of the P panel equal to 1000. Before that, here you can see that here we are using PSO MPPT and battery charger control concept. The PSO will receive two input voltage and current, and then output will be duty cycle. Here we are measuring the SOC of the battery, the voltage of the battery, based upon, and then here we are comparing with the 100, and here we are comparing with the over voltage of the battery. Based upon this comparison, we are going to allow this duty cycle. If both condition is true, it's going to allow this duty cycle, and then it will be processed by PWM generator to control the bi-directional converter, or else it will be blocked this duty cycle. The bi-directional converter has not operated. This is a IP-based battery charger controller and MPPT controller. First, I'm going to explain this system with the solar power module. PV having power, we will see the results. First, I'm going to make irradiation equal to 1000. Here you can see that because of high irradiation, what will be happened, the solar generating the power, this voltage of PV is around 100 volt, PV current is around 16 amps, and then PV power we are here is around 1700, right? So here you can see that this is battery holding, battery current, battery power. Here you can see the current is negative. What's the meaning? And that means solar is generating the excess power. That's why battery in charging mode. And also here you can see that we are not using a backup generator or AC input. The voltage of our diffuser and can be zero. The power is zero. So here you can see that the AC load. This is AC load, and then you can AC load voltage. So here you can see that this is sinusoidal. Here the AC load is continuously getting the power from the PV, and the excess power going to charge the battery. Now I'm going to make the PV irradiation equal to zero. So we will check the result after that. Now I change this irradiation of PV is zero. Now we can see that the PV power is comes to zero because irradiation goes to zero. Because of irradiation goes to zero, we are getting power will be zero. Here you can see the power will be zero. And then you can see that now the battery comes, when battery current change from negative to positive, that means it go for a discharging mode. And also you can see that the power, that when discharging power is around 900 watts. And also you can see that the AC load continuously getting the supplying from the battery. Because of absence of PV, now battery supplying the power to the AC load. For example, now we consider SOC of the battery is very low. Now I'm going to connect the generator set. So I'm going to include the generator set. And then you will see the result of the system. Now, because of inclusion of the generator set, now we can see that the rectifier voltage is increased and current increased because of connection of generator set. Now, this generator set supplying the power to the AC load, as well as here you can see that the water cover generated from the rectifier that directly drive this AC load. So it will be maintained constant. The main battery power is maintained constant. Now, I'm going to increase the irradiation of the system. Now we can see the variation of the system output. Because of increasing irradiation, we can see that the PV power increased, so the power will be, excess power will be charged the battery as well as supply the AC load. So here you can see that sharing of the generator set will be decreased to 500 watts because of PV generating some power. That's why the power sharing of the generator set is reduced. If suppose again I'm going to decrease the PV power, and then we will check the result. Now you can see that because of reduction PV, battery will be in goes to ideal condition, and then we are getting power from the generator set, and then it will supply the power to the AC load. This is the operation of off-grid solar PV system. Thanks for watching our videos. Kindly subscribe our channel and also the bell icon for notification of our upcoming videos. Thank you so much. Bye bye.